Hello and a warm welcome to you all for my next video series lectures on multiple integrals. This is the first part of this series, which focuses on the basic evaluation of double integrals. So I start by defining what a double integral is, and then I focus on the various types of evaluation, mainly when the limits are constants and the limits are variable limits, how to choose the order of integration and to perform this double integral. So this is a very basic video which will act as a foundation for the remaining. So I hope you benefit out of it. So let's begin. So let's begin with understanding what we mean by double integrals. I'm sure you all agree that we have studied about single integrals in school level mathematics, wherein we learned how to evaluate a function of a single variable, say x, between certain limits x1, x2. So we used our standard usual formulae to evaluate the integral and then substituted these constant limits. If you remember, we had all the limits to be constants and then we performed integration to get the answer. Now suppose we are talking about a function of more than one variable, say two variables x, y, and we wish to integrate f of x, y. So it's understood that we need to do it with respect to two variables x and y, and therefore we need two integral symbols to be placed and to integrate with respect to not only x but also with respect to y. There are two integrals here. There's one inner integral and an outer integral. So we call the one which is written to the outer side to be an outer integral and the one which is written inside to be an inner integral. The integration is now to be performed, as we have stated here, as dx dy. So the limits of the inner integral will be that of x and limits of the outer integral will be that of y. Sometimes in some problems it is very trickily written, so we have to identify them in the proper way. For now, we shall understand that when we write dx dy, we are mentioning the limits of x in the inner integral and the limits of y as y1, y2 in the outer integral. So this symbol overall that we write, we shall call it by the letter I. So I represents a double integral of the integrand f of xy, which is integrated with respect to x and y between the limits x1 to x2 and y1 to y2. So this is the basic definition of a double integral. Now what does this mean? This means that the evaluation of this double integral is done in the following manner. The inner integral is evaluated first, and that is to be done with respect to the variable x, because we are given the inner integral as the x here and the limits are also for x here. So we are integrating with respect to y. Integrating what? We are integrating the integrand as with respect to x. But what's happening to y then? Temporarily in that state, y is assumed to be a constant and the integration is performed. So there is an expression that you get on evaluating the inner integral, and that expression further is now integrated with the next variable y. So the result of the inner integral. So what do you mean by expression? It is nothing but the result of the inner integral. So the inner integral is evaluated and that result is now integrated with respect to the variable y, and the result is obtained. So this is the evaluation pattern. I repeat, the inner integral is evaluated first with respect to x. We took up because we are having the order as dx dy. So x refers to the limits here of the inner integral. X is the integration done first, then y is for the outer integral. So the inner integral is evaluated first by treating y to be a constant. Then the result that we obtain in the of the inner integral is then evaluated with respect to y, and then the result is obtained. So always note that the results or the limits of the outer integral will always be constants. the limits of, that is y1 and y2, will always be constant since they are representing the outer limits. Whereas the inner limits, x1 and x2, because they are all limits for the variable x, they could either be constants or they could also be, in some cases, they could also be functions of y. They are limits of x. They are limits of x. So these could either be constants or they are limits of the other variable, which is y here. And y is, integration with respect to y is yet to be performed. So this is accepted. Whereas the limits of the outer integral will always be constants. That is to be kept in mind. So therefore, this integral can now be rewritten in a more simplified manner, or arranged in a more simplified manner this way. I is equal to, write the outer integral first, that is y1 to y2, then let's put a bracket, and then let's write the inner integral x1 to x2, then let's write the integrand f of xy, and now you are integrating with respect to x, so you write it as dx, close the bracket, and then you integrate with respect to y. So here, what are we doing? Integration is performed with respect to x, so y is treated to be a constant in that particular step. And once integration is done, the result is obtained. So this is the rearrangement of the regular double integral. So we shall rearrange every problem in this manner, then evaluate the inner integral based on the limits given and based on the variable of integration. The result will again be integrated with respect to the other variable, noting that the outer limits will always be constants, and thereby giving us the value of the double integral. Let's now study this concept in some of our problems. Let us now start by solving certain problems of evaluating double integrals. There are two types. Type 1 deals with the case when the evaluation is based on constant limits, and type 2 is when they are given in terms of variable limits. Now, in terms of constant limits, the problem is very simple, as we do not have to worry about the order in which we are evaluating. The order is as given in the problem. So there is no problem of deciding whether you have to integrate with respect to x first or y first when they are constant limits. Whereas when they are variable limits, we need to very carefully identify the variable in the inner integral. So only once you understand or analyze the variable that is given in the inner integral, can you decide the order. So the order is easy to discuss in the case when it is a constant limit. We shall first of all focus on those type of problems first, which will merely tell us how to decide or how to evaluate a general constant limit problem. So let's start with problem number one. The question reads, evaluate I is equal to integral 0 to b, integral 0 to a, xy into x minus y, dx dy. So as I told you a few minutes before, if you say it's constant limits, then the order of integration is as given in the problem, meaning that dx dy is the order given. So that means x limits are from 0 to a and y limits are from 0 to b. So the order is x first. First is with respect to x between the limits 0 to a, and the second is with respect to y between 0 to b. So the region is also very similar. We can decide, though we do not require what the region here is for evaluation purpose, but we shall still see in which region is this integral evaluated. So the limits are, the boundaries of the region are x equal to 0 and x equal to a, because the limits of x are from 0 to a, and the other two boundaries are y equal to 0 and y is equal to b, because y varies from 0 to b. I am sure you all recognize that these are general four straight lines. So let us take up the simple coordinate plane and show all these lines. X equal to 0 is the y axis, y equal to 0 is the x axis, y is equal to b is a line parallel to the y x axis, and x is equal to a is a line parallel to the y axis. So what is the region which we are discussing here? I am sure you can guess that the region is nothing but the rectangular part in which we have to evaluate this particular integral. Though this region, finding the region, is not of importance in this particular problem because we are focusing only on evaluation, but still, as the limits are given, it is to be understood where the region, where this integral is evaluated. So we understand that this integral is evaluated in the rectangular region. Now, coming back to the basic evaluation where the question reads evaluate, we shall rewrite the outer integral as 0 to b. Then we shall put a bracket as we discussed in the previous slide. Then write the limits of x from 0 to a, and then simplify the bracket so it becomes x square y minus x y square. And you are integrating with respect to x first, and then you're closing the bracket, and then you are integrating with respect to y. So this is has to be integrated now, which we shall see in our next slide. So let's continue with the problem. We're integrating the inner integral, so we keep the outer integral as it is. And on integrating x square y, we get, with respect to x, we get x cube y by 3. And on integrating x y square, with respect to x, we get x square y square by 2. With the limits varying from 0 to a, and further we need to integrate with respect to y. So continuing in the same manner, let us now apply the limits for x. So instead of x, we are replacing a, so it becomes a cube y by 3 minus a square y square divided by 2. Lower limit on substituting x is 0, we get 0, so lower limit there is no contribution, so leave it as it is. Now we have an expression. So this is the expression. This is the result which we have said of the inner integral. If you remember, we said the inner integral has to be evaluated first. So this is what it is. And now we shall integrate it with respect to y. It becomes a cube y square by 6, because it's 3 into 2, minus a square y cube by 3 into 2, it is 6. And now let us substitute the limits from 0 to b. Substituting the upper limit will now give me a cube b square divided by 6 minus a square b cube divided by 6, and lower limit will give you 0 because y is 0 in both the terms. So we take out here, which is certain common terms, and declare the answer. A square can be taken out, b square can be taken out, divided by 6 can be taken out, and what is left here is a minus b. So the solution of this, or evaluation of the double integral, is complete, and the result is a square b square by 6 divided by a minus b. So that's your result. So I hope it is clear to all of you that the basic evaluation of the integral is to be done in this manner. Let's take up one more problem to understand it further. Let's start with problem number 2, which reads, evaluate double integral. The limits here now are for theta and phi. These are the two variables we take. The integrand is sine of theta plus phi, d theta d phi, where the theta values are lower limit values are 0 to pi by 2, and the outer limit values are 0 to pi by 2. So the variables of integration are theta and phi, unlike we had x and y in the previous case. So if you note here again, the limits are 0 to pi by 2 everywhere. So the limits are constants. So again, the order of integration is as given in the problem because the limits are constant limits. So the limits are constants. So there is no big problem here. So what is the order of integration? It is theta and phi. So theta limits are 0 to pi by 2, that is the inner integral, and phi limits are in outer integral limits, which is theta equal to pi by theta to pi by 2 again. So both the limits though are the same. So the order of integration is first, that is the inner integral is with respect to theta, and the second integral is with respect to phi. So it's only a change in the function that we have when we compare it with the first problem. What is the region? Let us see. The region is bounded by four lines again. What are the four lines? Here we have theta equal to 0, theta equal to pi by 2. That's two lines of theta. Phi is equal to 0 and phi is equal to pi by 2. As we drew a rectangle in the previous case, here it becomes a square. So if you take the lines, this will be phi equal to 0. If you take, this is your theta axis. This is your theta axis and this is your phi axis. And treat this to be theta is equal to 0. A line parallel to phi equal to 0 is phi equal to pi by 2. A line parallel to theta equal to 0 is theta is equal to pi by 2. So what is the region here? It is in this region that we are asked to evaluate the double integral. So everything is understood now. So let's complete, let's rewrite or rearrange the given interval in a proper form. Writing I to B, write the outer integral first, 0 to pi by 2. Put a bracket. Now this is for which function? It is for phi. Then you write inner integral is for theta, which is again it is 0 to pi by 2. And then you have sine function, argument being theta plus phi. You are integrating with respect to theta and later you integrate with respect to phi. So as we have understood that this phi should be treated to be a constant as we are integrating with respect to theta first. So let's do the inner evaluation, 0 to pi by 2. Now we are integrating a sine function. I'm sure you all know that integral of sine is minus cos. So it is minus cos of theta plus phi divided by, you are integrating with respect to theta. So the coefficient of theta is 1 and phi here is a constant. So it is 1 plus 0. The limits vary from 0 to pi by 2. And then you have to integrate this result with respect to phi. So let's continue doing this in our next slide. So we get I is equal to, write the outer integral again, it is 0 to pi by 2, that minus term which you have, we can pull it out. Let us substitute the upper limit first. We are substituting for the variable theta as pi by 2, so it is cos of pi by 2 plus phi, that is the upper limit. Then you are substituting the lower limit for theta as 0, so it is cos of 0 plus phi. That's what you have, and then the another integration which has to be performed is d phi with respect to phi. Now kindly note that we have a formula in trigonometry, cos of pi by 2 plus phi is equal to minus sine phi. I'm sure all of you are aware of this formula. It's basic trigonometry. So when it comes to this, you substitute it, integral 0 to pi by 2, and now substitute that minus sine phi here. And this becomes minus 0 plus phi here is cos phi, and then to be integrated with respect to phi. We can pull out the minus sign, so minus of minus becomes plus here. And so integral 0 to pi by 2, no, this is, it can, if we can remove that, in fact we could do it direct integration too. I have removed both the signs here, so both are positive. And now let us perform the integration. Integral sine phi is minus cos phi, and integral cos phi is sine phi, and we need to substitute the limits from 0 to pi by 2. So I'll recall that cos 0 is, so we can recall the formulae, sine 0 is 0, sine pi by 2 is 1, cos 0 is 1, and cos pi by 2 is 0. This also we are all aware of. So let us substitute these values in our next slide. So substituting all the values, we get I is equal to 0 plus 1 minus of minus 1 plus 0, which makes it I is equal to 2. So this is the solution of the double integral. I hope the two problems have given us insight into how to evaluate them directly. The only point to remember is when we have constant limits, the problem is a very simple one because we do not have any confusion over the order. So the order of integration is as given in the problem. So this is what we need to understand, and this is possible only for constant limits. Let us now take up the case when the limits are not constants, but the limits are variable. So variable limits is what we will focus on now. Now this can be understood easily because the basic format is understood. So let us take up some problems directly and then learn it from them. So question number one is to evaluate I is equal to. So let's take the problem as integral 0 to 2 is the outer limits. Inner integral is 0 to x square e to the power y by x. And your integration is done as dx dy. So very important to note that here you have a variable limit. So one limit, though the other three are 0, 0 and 2, there is one variable limit. So we cannot guess that the order is the same as given. We need to think before we really start off doing the problem. So let us first of all write the given limits. So the given limits here are, so here you are saying that is, there is an x here, the first term that is given to you is x, whereas you have to look at the inner limits of the inner integral. The limits of the inner integral are functions of x. It's a constant and there's a function of x. So as we studied, you cannot have x limits as functions of itself. So since it's a function of x, these will represent the limits of y. So therefore, given limits are y varies from 0 to x square. So that point is to be understood first. Look at the inner limits first. If the inner limits are functions of x, that means they represent the limits for y, and vice versa. Since you have x square here, these will represent the limits of y, and thereafter the outer limits are obviously for x from 0 to 2. So how do we decide the region? So that means we have, suppose let us draw the curves here. So the region's boundaries are y equal to 0, y equal to x square, x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 2. So this, the region is bounded by these lines and curves. So this is the region that is specified to us based on our understanding. So if we draw them to understand, y equal to 0 is a line, x equal to 0 is a line, x equal to 2 is a line, whereas y equal to x square is a parabola which is opening upwards. So let us draw the parabola first. So if we take this as the x-axis, the y-axis, y equal to x square is a parabola opening upwards. So that's the parabola. So that's y is equal to x square. Then you have y is equal to 0, which is the x-axis. Then you have x is equal to 0, which is the y-axis. And you have x equal to 2, which is a line parallel to the y-axis. So let's draw it this way. So this is x is equal to 2. Now you see there's a region that is formed. Now you can easily see there's a region that is formed here. So this will be the region. Okay. In this region, we are evaluating the particular integral. So x is bounded from 0 to x square. So it's just to decide, just to know what the region is, that we have drawn a figure like this to understand what is the region that we are deciding. So this is the region where in which the evaluation is done. So we need to learn how to draw these figures. Y equal to 0 as x square, as I repeat, is a parabola. So that's a parabola that we have defined here. So y equal to x square is a parabola. Then x is equal to 2 is a line parallel to the y-axis. Y equal to 0 is the x-axis, and x equal to 0 is the y-axis. So what is the region which is the combined region of the four lines, the four curves, is this region. So in this region, let us first start to evaluate the particular double integral. So let's write the order in which we are going to evaluate. The order in which we are going to evaluate is, first, where do you think we should do? Since we have said y0 to x square is y, first is with respect to y. And the second is with respect to x. So let's now do that in our next slide. So I is equal to, let's rewrite it. Let's write the y x limits outside. X varying from 0 to 2, open a bracket. Then write y varying from 0 to x square. E to the power, this is x square. E to the power y by x, you are integrating with respect to y and then dx. So this is where we are very keenly see that this does not coincide with what is given in the question. The question which was given was dx dy. So we cannot go ahead. It's wrong actually. We had to understand it based on the limits of the inner integral. So as such, the integration here is done in this order and not in order. But given order, we could do only when the limits were constants. Please remember that. So this is integral 0 to 2, which is kept as it is. And when we are integrating e power y by x with respect to y, so you get e power y by x divided by 1 by x. I'm sure this also is known. And the limits varying from 0 to x square and then integral to be done with respect to x. The formula that I am using here is integral e power ay. If you note that it is ay dy is equal to e power ay divided by a, and here a is equal to 1 by x. So this is only for us to recall the general formula that we all know and which we have applied it here. Now let me substitute the upper limit and the lower limit one by one. So it becomes e to the power. So you have x into, so I'll write that x outside. 1 by x can be taken out. So it's x outside, x square divided by x. Then lower limit is e power 0, which is 1 multiplied by x. And so this is nothing but integral. I will write it in my next slide. So let us simplify the bracket now, and it becomes integral 0 to 2 x into e power x square by x becomes x, and e power 0 is 1. So we get a product of terms which have to be integrated, which we use the Bernoulli rule. And Bernoulli's rule is the extension of integration by parts. So it states that if u and v are functions of x, then the product uv can be written as uv1 minus u dash v2 plus u double dash v3 minus u triple dash v4 with alternate plus and minus sign and so on, where u dash, u double dash, u triple dash, etc. are all successive derivatives of u, and v1, v2, etc. are all successive integrals of v. So we choose u and v in this product as u is equal to x. We go on successively differentiating u until we get the term 0. And we take the other part to be e power x minus 1 as v and go on successively integrating it. So e power x integral is e power x. 1 integral is x. Then again we integrate e power x, you get e power x. Integrating x, we get x square by 2. We stop it at this stage. That is when the second order derivative is 0. We go ahead up till finding out the second integral. So then we multiply u and v1, that's the first term in the formula, with a plus sign. So introduce a plus sign. The formula has an alternate plus and minus. Then we multiply u dash and v2 and attach a minus sign to that term. And if the terms proceed, that's how we continue with alternate plus and minus sign and rewrite the answer in just one line. So the value of I therefore is u into v1. That means it is x into e power x minus x multiplied by a plus sign. So it's a plus sign. The next term is the product of u dash and v2 with a negative sign. So it is minus 1 into e power x minus x square by 2. So we are multiplying that u dash and v2 and attaching a negative sign to it. This can be remembered like this. You can start with the sign and then multiply the corresponding ends of the arrow. So it is plus x into e power x minus x. So that's the first term. The second term is minus into 1 into e power x minus x square by 2. So let's start with the sign and then multiply the two ends. So that way in one line you get the complete result of that particular integration. Now, let us now evaluate the substitution by putting the upper limit as 2 and the lower limit as 0. So finally it reduces to 2 e power x minus 2 into 2 is 4 minus of e power 2 minus 2 square by 2, which is 2. Lower limit, the first term is 0. E power 0 is 1, so with a minus sign, so it gives you 1. And here it's e to e square. And therefore, on simplifying, I get I is equal to e square minus 4 plus 2 is minus 2 plus 1, so it is minus 1. And that completes the result of this particular problem. So we have noticed that when there is a variable limit, there are two points to note. That is, number one, the variable that is used in the variable used in the inner integral. That is very important. That decides the inner integral evaluation. The variable used in the inner integral has to be tested first and then decided. And then if you have a product to be integrated, then apply the Bernoulli rule. So these are the two things that we have learnt newly in this particular problem. And we shall apply similar results to the next one too, which will be another variable limit problem. Let's take up the next problem under this category. I is equal to double integral. The outer limits are 0 to 1 and the inner integral limits are 0 to root of 1 minus y square. The integrand is 1 by 1 plus x square minus y square. Integration that is given to you in the problem is dx dy. So this is again a variable limit problem because you have one of the limits to be root 1 minus y square. And the first step, as we discussed in the previous problem, is if the limits of the inner integral are functions of y, that means they must represent the limits for the variable x. So x limits are the ones which we have to integrate first. So it is 0 to root over 1 minus y square. So the inner limits are nothing but for x and the outer limits are for y. How did we decide it? Based on the function that we have in one of the limits as root 1 minus y square. And as I said, if you have y as a function there, then it should be the limit for the variable x. So what we have written as x from 0 to root 1 minus y square is correct. And we also have the order that is specified in the problem that is right. And thereafter, y value limits will vary from 0 to 1. Let us also decide the region that is, though it is not material for us now, but let us also identify what is the region in which we are evaluating this integral. So as we said, the limits are x and y given in these two forms. So the curves are x equal to 0, x equal to 1 minus y square. On evaluating this, we get it's actually square root. So when you square both sides, I get x square plus y square equal to 1, which is a circle with center at 0, 0 and radius as 1. So you are given a circular part. You're given two lines x is equal to 0, another two lines y equal to 0 and y equal to 1. That is from the outer integral. So if we have to define what is the region behind it, let us draw the region first by drawing the coordinate system. So the coordinate system, the two-dimensional coordinate system, let's draw the x and y axis this way. Then as it's a circle with center at origin and radius 1, we shall draw a small circle with radius as 1. And you have y is equal to 0 here. You have x is equal to 0 here. And this is y is equal to 1 because the radius is 1. So y is equal to 1 is a tangent to that circle. And this is nothing but x square plus y square is equal to 1, which is a circular point. So if you can look at the region now, the region is bounded by x equal to 0, y equal to 0, y equal to 1 and the circle. So it will be this part which we are focusing on. So though we do not need a region now, we do not need a region or to identify it, but a direct evaluation is sufficient in this problem. Yet because there are variable limits, it is possible to draw geometrically to identify in which region the integral is evaluated. So let's continue now with the general evaluation. So I rewrite I to be equal to, the outer limit is first 0 to 1, then we draw a bracket and then write integral x varying from 0 to root over 1 minus y square. The integrand that we have is 1 by, so we are integrating with respect to x, and so I will write x square plus the remaining, as y is a constant, I have 1 minus y square, and that 1 minus y square, I will rewrite it as root over 1 minus y square, the whole square. I integrate it with respect to x, then close the bracket and write it as dy. So this is how I project. Now I repeat what I have done. As we are integrating with respect to x, I write x square term separately and y is treated to be a constant. So it is 1 minus y square is the constant, which I will rewrite it as root over 1 minus y square the whole square. The reason I do it is so that we can recognize there is a pattern and there's a formula to apply. So let's see what's that formula in my next slide. Recall a formula of the kind, integral dx divided by x square plus a square, and that's nothing but 1 by a times tan inverse of x by a. Now here in our problem, in our previous step, here the value of a that we are looking for is root of 1 minus y square. So let's apply this formula and then rewrite the value of I. So I therefore is equal to integral 0 to 1 is the outer limit, 1 by a. So we say 1 by, what is a here? Root over 1 minus y square. Then you have tan inverse of x by a. So we shall write it as x divided by root over 1 minus y square. The limits now varying from 0 to root over 1 minus y square, and the integration to be performed with respect to y afterwards. So therefore, this becomes integral 0 to 1. Let's substitute the upper limits. So I get root over 1 by root over 1 minus y square, tan inverse of, x is substituted as root, so root by root cancels out. So it's root 1 minus y square by root 1 minus y square. The lower limit is 0, substituting x as 0. So it is 1 divided by root over 1 minus y square into tan inverse of 0. And there ends the substitution, and rewrite it as dy and simplify it. So this gets cancelled, giving you 1 here. So tan inverse 1, we are aware, it is 0 to 1, 1 by root 1 minus y square. Tan inverse of 1 is pi by 4. Tan inverse of 0 is 0. So this entire term gets cancelled. So what we are left is with this. And now let's substitute it. Let's take out pi by 4 common. Let's take outside the integral. So let's write I is equal to pi by 4 multiplied by the integral 0 to 1. 1 divided by root over 1 minus y square dy. Again, we have a formula ready made for this. We have integral dy divided by root over a square minus y square is nothing but sine inverse of y by a. Here, what is a? The value of a here is 1. So we substitute it directly. So this becomes pi by 4 times sine inverse y. Sine inverse y is the integration value. Now the limit substitution remains from 0 to 1. So it becomes pi by 4 times sine inverse 1. So it is sine inverse of 1 minus sine inverse of 0. I'm sure it is all known that sine inverse 1 is nothing but pi by 2, where a sine inverse of 0 is 0, and hence the value of I is pi square divided by 8. So this is how we actually evaluate a double integral, whether it is with constant limits or with variable limits. So I hope these two problems of variable limits and two problems of constant limits have given you an idea to solve many more such problems. In the next video, we shall look at how to evaluate double integrals when a region is given. Though the region did not show much of prominence in these problems because the limits were given, whereas this video was only focused to show the evaluation of a general double integral. But in the next video, we shall take up regions, develop limits, and then integrate in a usual manner. So thank you for your cooperation, and let's meet in my next video.